Let's quickly look at an example of share buybacks. Let's assume that I have issued shares and the total shares that I issued was 100,000 shares at a price of, let's say, 2 rand per share. That is going to give me a total share capital raised, okay, as the business, of 200,000 rand. Good. So how will that look in my general ledger? Well, I'll have my T account, my bank account, the company will receive money, and they will receive 200,000. When I indicate like that, that simply means it's a 1,000. 200,000 rand received in cash. Now the opposite side of this entry is going to be on my ordinary share capital account. This is finances that I owe to the owners, and I have my credit leg on there. So that's my entry for the share issue. If I then were to have another share issue, let's say of 200,000 rand at 4 rand this time. Now let's make it 100,000 rand again. Sorry, let's just take that out again there. Right, and let's make it 100,000 rand at 4 rand. That is going to give me 400,000 rand of share capital that I raised. And if I have to record that, that's going to be 400,000 rand that I receive in cash and 400,000 rand going to increase my ordinary share capital. Good, so that's the situation at this stage. What we can say then is that in total we've got 200,000 shares in issue, and the total share capital that we have is 600,000. Alright, the question is, what is my price here? And I can find that pretty easily. We can say that I've got 200,000 shares in issue at an average price of, which is what we're going to calculate here, an average price, which is equal to the total share capital divided by the total shares in issue. So that's going to be 600,000 divided by the 200,000, which is going to give me an average issue price of 3 rand per share. Okay, so there we go. It's 3 rand per share. So this is what happens if we are issuing shares. So the company is obtaining financing because they want to expand their activities. Now, for some reason, if the company wants to buy back some of this share capital that it issued for numerous reasons, for example, there's a shareholder that has got close to a controlling interest in the entity, so he almost owns more than 50% of the entity, then the company may want to actually buy back those shares. Now, if the company does then go and buy back the shares, let's assume the company buys back $10,000 shares at 3.50 rand each. So we can call this price the buyback price. So how is this going to look on my general ledger? So the total buyback price is going to be 10,000 multiplied by the 3.50 rand, which is equal to 35,000 rand. Now, how much of this 35,000 rand is going to decrease my ordinary share capital? Well, we know we're giving out 35,000 rand, so my bank needs to decrease by this 35,000 rand, so I can record 35,000 rand on the credit side of my bank account. If I buy back 10,000 of these 200,000 shares, I've seen that each share has an average issue price of 3 rand, which means that I've actually bought back share capital. So share capital repurchased is going to be the 10,000 rand, the 10,000 shares times the 3 rand per share average issue price. When I buy back the share capital, I have to buy that back at the average issue price. So that's going to give me a total share capital repurchased of 30,000 rand. 30,000 rand I can put in there. So you can see I've got a credit of 35 and a debit of 30. So now I still need a debit of 5,000 rand. And where is that going to go? First of all, it's probably important to understand why the buyback, the total buyback price, is greater than the share capital invested. Now, when the shareholder originally bought these shares on the credit side, they bought that at the issue price. But obviously, as the time goes by, hopefully the company does well and the value of the shares increase. So when it comes to a stage when the company now wants to buy back the share from the owner, they are probably going to have to buy that back at a premium. And that is why the buyback price of 35,000 rand is slightly higher than the average issue price of those shares being bought back. So the portion above the average issue price is going to be 35,000 rand minus the 30,000 rand, and we are going to recover that, which is equal to 5,000 rand, from my retained earnings account. Retained income. Right, so this amount is going to be 5,000 on the debit side. So you can see that by buyback, my total buyback of 35,000 rand has been split between the share capital repurchased, number one, and then the second part is the portion above the average issue price, which is the total buyback, 35, minus the share capital repurchased, which gave me the 5,000, and that goes from the retained income account. Good. Just a quick recap. We can say that this 35,000 rand, we calculate it with the number of shares bought back, and we multiply that by the buyback price. Alright, so that was the buyback price. Alright, here the original issue was obviously at the original, the number of shares issued multiplied by the issue price. Alright. And then our buyback of the ordinary share capital was the number of shares bought back again. Number of shares bought back, which we have here. 10,000 shares bought back. And this we did at the average issue price. So this is the one that we had to calculate here at the beginning, the 3 rand per share. So there we go. This is the average issue price. The total buyback payment is at the buyback price. Both of them use the number of shares bought back. And then lastly, my retained income is simply the difference between the total buyback price and the ordinary share capital that we've effectively bought back. So you can calculate it like that. Or you can say it's the number of shares bought back multiplied by my buyback price minus the average issue price, which in essence is the same as saying 35 minus the 30. The calculation there, if you wanted to calculate that, would be 10,000 times 3 rand 50 minus 3 rand, which will be 10,000 times 50 cents, which is going to be my 5,000 rand. So important then, when we are recording the buyback of shares, that we first calculate our average issue price, and thereafter we need to split our total buyback, which will obviously come on the credit side of bank because we are giving out money. We split this total buyback between the share capital being repurchased and the retained income, which is the additional value that the shares have gained, either due to the passing of time and the growth in the shares, or due to dividends that was never distributed to the shareholders. Good.